So when you started fighting, when you began your amateur career, there was nowhere to go, right? I mean, had Invicta started when you began your amateur career?
Yes, Invicta was around. So for people not familiar with it, Invicta is the first, like, just women pro league MMA. So that's where we can go, because the UFC was not yet open to women. And Dana White at that point had said he'll never have them in the UFC. It's as I was coming up. And I think I was a young pro at the time, possibly a late amateur, but I think I was a pro. And that's when Ronda Rousey came about. So lover or hater, and a lot of people talk crap, you can be nothing but grateful because she's the one that opened the doors to get where we all are now. So as soon as Dana accepted women to the UFC, it went from me as like, okay, I'm going to do this part-time. This will be what I do for fun, and I'm going to have a job over here. So that was my intent. And then when the doors opened to UFC and I say, oh my gosh, I can make a living at this. This could be what I do, because I was good at it. I enjoyed it. And it's most things that you enjoy that much and you are able to engage in the passion and just doing well at it, it kind of added up.
So did you have athletic, were your parents or your relatives, were they athletes? Because I do believe like 70% of it at some point is just all mental. But you have to have that basic athletic background. And so because you had a really fast rise. And so I've always wondered if you had like a background of athletes in your family that you got some stuff from.
Yes and no. So it seems fast, but 10 years. So, but that is fast when you look at it.
But you went from your first fight to your first fight as a pro within two.
Yeah.
Within 2 years.
After my first pro fight, we came home. That was my 20th birthday. So yeah, about 2 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it slowed down a little bit as a pro, especially in the transition from Invicta to the UFC and then this last year, which we can talk about if you want.
Yeah, I'll talk about it later.
Yeah. But no, as far as athletic ability, yeah, my mom was a Division I softball player.
Okay.
And that was that. And my dad was just normal, athletic, good old boy and several other things growing up. Mm-hmm. And me younger, I did some ballet for quite a while. And then I got into distance running with my dad a little bit after that. And then there is other things like skiing and things, but that was just for fun.
Did the ballet help?
I don't know. I did it for about 5 years when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. And I think any form of athletic, anything, you have to be a schedule, being strict, just learning. Yes, the discipline of it. I think whatever it is, it doesn't matter. It's going to help a kid. It's just learning the structure. Mm-hmm. So in that way, I'm sure it did. Athletically, I think I've always just been a little, I need something to do.
So. You're like a husky?
Yeah. There's a reason we get along well.
So, yeah, I mean, when I was looking at your record, I mean, or at your journey, and it's like less than 2 years, man, from your first stepping into a ring as an amateur with that hair to getting into your first pro fight with the braids. I mean, that was pretty quick. That's impressive. So Invicta was around, so you probably thought, okay, well, this is what I'm doing, Invicta, right?
Yeah, no, I was happy too. I was very grateful for the opportunity, and I still am. Invicta is amazing. So there's certain things, and I think some fighters coming up, they're coming up too fast almost. And as you're saying, that is fast, but there is levels to it. I did. So everybody needs to do amateurs for a while, in my opinion. That's where you learn. You take a loss, you get better. You learn what you're doing and how you're doing it. So as the late stage amateur, I think there's a promotion you should always fight for. It's Tough Enough in Vegas, and they treat you kind of like a pro. So you fly in, you learn how to fight and travel and do everything that you need
again?
To do.
Tough Enough? Tough Enough, okay.
They do pro-ams now too, but as like your last amateur step, you should go there. And then for a guy, there's a few options. There's like LFA, CFFC. But for women, really, the pinnacle of it, before the UFC now, because that's open, it's Invicta. That's where you want to go. They're extremely professional, and they run their show exactly like the UFC does. So
Same rules.
Same. They treat you the same. You have to do media the same. Everything is very similar. You got to follow their itinerary when you get there, kind of thing. So once you go through that system, and you're fighting all the best girls, like it's great competition. So once you go through that, by the time you're signed to the UFC, it's like, oh, it's bigger, but it's all familiar. Mm-hmm. It's not just the fight, it's learning everything up until the fight, following all the rules, following the itinerary, doing the media while you're cutting weight. It's just, it prepares you for that next step.